Football has a lot of meaning and weight to people in Tuscaloosa, whether you're a Bama fan or not.
Andrea Mattei sat down with a football player who was here in 2011 and talked about how April 27th and the days and months that followed transformed that year's team.
When people think about Tuscaloosa, they think about the University of Alabama and its championship football program. When a tornado hit the community in 2011, football players turned into cleanup volunteers, showing their bond with Tuscaloosa is way bigger than just football.
I think when that happened, I think it helped everybody, from Coach Saban on down, to really realize some perspective and to think about, you know, football is really important, but there are things that are much more important. And so I think in some ways that perspective helped us play well that year.
Former Alabama football guard Barrett Jones was part of the 2011 National Championship team. He was going into his fourth season when the EF4 tornado hit Tuscaloosa. He says he was at his apartment with friends that afternoon. When the storm rolled in, he lost power and decided to go up on the roof.
So we went up and got on the roof, and we saw the tornado coming towards Tuscaloosa. It was coming from our field of vision, from right to left, and it looked like it was heading right for the stadium from our vision. You know, in one sense, it was a sight to behold, but then on the other sense, you really knew the kind of damage that it was inflicting and probably that people were losing their lives.
The next day, Coach Nick Saban called a meeting to check on all of the players. Long snapper Carson Tinker was hurt, and his girlfriend passed away.
You know, Coach Saban kind of said to us, guys, I want you to really just forget about football and focus on finding ways to serve in the community. There's a lot of things happening right here that are bigger than football. And I saw a change in his countenance that day that I think is still kind of stuck with him, of just realizing the impact, that he could have on the community, because he jumped into action immediately, and I think a lot of us followed suit.
In the days after the tornado, Jones and his teammates traded their pads for work gloves and helped clean up debris. Jones says he worked mostly along 15th Street, where most of the damage was. The football team also helped with some Habitat for Humanity bills through the partnership with Nick's Kids. At the time, they had 13 national championships, so 13 houses were built. Jones says those experiences shaped the young men on the team and gave them new perspective they were able to take with them into the next season and into these last 10 years.
You know, there definitely were some people that kind of recognized me out there that I was working, but because we were working towards such a bigger cause, it was almost just an understanding where, you know, it didn't matter who you were, it didn't matter what background you came from, or if you were from Tuscaloosa, if you're from somewhere else, we were there to work, and we were there to try to help out. And so it definitely was cool to be able to have an impact, and especially when I was with other players and we'd go out and pass stuff out. I think that was a neat experience, because it did maybe momentarily lift some people's spirits, but it continued to weigh heavy on our hearts. And I think even throughout the whole season, we really felt a sense of that we were, playing for more. And I do remember the first home game that we had. You know, we all gathered together, and it kind of felt like the first time that the city, was back in one spot again. Obviously, Tuscaloosa is not that big of a town, and you have over 100,000 people in one place, a lot of them from Tuscaloosa. It was a really emotional moment. Because for the first time in a long time, I think things kind of felt normal a little bit. It helped us all zoom out a little bit and get some perspective, because I think we all had our noses so deep down in football that it changed everybody. But the way that he led in that crisis, I think it will be a big part of his legacy and the impact he's had on the city. So really grateful for, that time in some ways, because I do think it helped shape and mold us. And, sometimes when you experience adversity, it can build character. And I think hopefully it builds some character in all of us.